So you're a software engineer, right? And like a painter with his paintbrush, a writer with his pen, and a musician with his guitar, you need certain tools to perform your art. And in this video, I'll go over the tools I cannot live without as a software engineer. Let's first start with la pièce de résistance, the one and only MacBook Pro. I know some of you might not agree about macOS being the best computer for development, but does your computer make you feel like a badass switching Windows like this? It has an M2 Pro chip with 32GB of RAM, and it's a total beast. It never breaks a sweat and is so silent you can hear a pin drop, even when running the most hardcore code or rendering some heavy 4K footage. In the past, I've been coding with both Windows and Linux, but there's something with the Mac that just makes it work and I absolutely love it. Next, we have the monitor, and yes, I'm jealous of all of you with those 5K studio display. But I've been running this bad boy for quite a while now, and it gets the job done. It's a 1440p 27-inch monitor from Dell with USB-C connectivity, so it's super convenient. And I already heard you saying, you only work with one monitor? Yes, I do, and I love it. I had it all before, the two, the three, even the four monitor setup, but I felt like each monitor brought more distraction and actual efficiency, so I said, it. Let's just work with one monitor from now on. It stayed like that for the past 2 years and it haven't even slowed me down. Let's get to real business, shall we, because we're talking about the keyboard and mouse. I've been rocking the Logitech MX keys and the MX Master 3 combo for a long time now, and I have absolutely no complaint. I love that you can switch easily from one computer to another with just one button. The tactile feeling of the keyboard is pretty good, and the mouse feels great in the hand. I might need to try out one of those mechanical keyboards one day, but for now, I'm plenty satisfied with that. And paired with this, I have the magic trackpad so I can still feel like a badass, even when I'm docked. Now, let's talk headphones for a minute. I've been using the AirPods Pro II for about a year and a half now. I used to use the Sony XM4 as my daily headphone previously, but when I bought the AirPods Pro, the Sony just started to collect dust. These bad boys are way more comfortable, and the noise cancelling is impressively almost as good. Once you put them on, the world around you just disappears, and you enter the flow, and you ship some features. Speaking of code, the IDE I use the most is obviously VS Code. It's like the Swiss Army knife of all IDE. You can code some React app, some Angular, some Node.js backend, some C# microservice, some full stack Elixir application, and you can even code some iOS app with it. Though, for this one, Xcode is definitely better. And it's so customizable, you can really make it look how you want. Then we have my good friend, ChatGPT. He's been in my life for about 2 years now, but boy did he change the things around here. I still remember the day I discovered him and I was asking him to write me some story. I was impressed, but since then, he's been my best coding bud. For the past few years, I've been trying on enough to learn about iOS development, but I was never able to keep up with the masterclass. It kinda never teach what I wanted to learn rapidly, so it always made me give up. But in the past few months, I've been building a budget app, and this time, instead of following tutorials, I have ChatGPT right alongside me. Then, finally, we have my favorite note-taking app. You probably know more about it than I do because of all of those YouTube videos dedicated to it, but even for its basic feature, Notion is fantastic. I basically have my whole life in here, from work task organization to meeting notes to my preparation for interviews lately to recipes to my YouTube backlog and like so much more. I know, I'm just scratching the surface here about everything that it can do, but I just love how simple yet so powerful it is. Well guys, that is pretty much the 7 tools I use the most as a software engineer. If there's other tools that I did not mention in the video that you use every day, please let us know in the comment section. But other than that, that's pretty much all I had for you today, so I'll see you soon.